On Thursday, the Office of the Prime Minister came on spot before the Public Accounts Committee on the project to promote coffee consumption in Uganda, where the government injected 9.6 billion shillings. The project sparked questions from legislators following Auditor General's findings that some coffee shops, which were meant to be established by Inspire Africa Limited through a public-private partnership, doesn't exist, while others are non-operational.
The Auditor General is saying the facility does not exist and equipment cannot be traced.
The coffee shop existed during the time we started and the training took place. We have the pictures and the reports. We have also the...
Pictures of what?
Of the training taking place and the functionality.
You can take a picture and we assume we're in training.
However, Inspire Africa, which implemented the project in 5 districts of eastern and northern Uganda, has come out to shed light on queries before Public Accounts Committee. They explained that the entire sum of 9.6 billion shillings did not go on training Ugandans to drink coffee, saying they carried out trainings of coffee farmers in Nyoya district and set up state-of-art coffee shops in 4 districts.
Trainings, we had exhibitions, we had festivals, we had boot camps. Now for the boot camps is where we got these young people, put them in a venue and skilled them in business, in entrepreneurship, in hands-on skills.
Roland Tayewa, the spokesperson of Inspire Africa, justified the government investment in promotion of domestic coffee consumption, saying countries like Ethiopia, which drink 50% of the locally produced coffee, leap much more than Uganda, which concentrates on coffee exports.
Our goal, as Inspire Africa, is to we want young people to understand coffee from the cup, not coffee as a cash crop, because we say that the gold is in the cup. Coffee is not a cash crop. Coffee is a beverage. Coffee is something you can drink.
He explained a need for Ugandans to change the narrative and treat coffee as a food crop instead of a cash crop produced for export only.
From a kilogram of coffee, just one, you get about 100 cups of coffee. Now, if you go to these fancy restaurants, they will be selling you a cup of coffee at 10,000. You can make them a calculation. If I bought this kilogram at 40,000, I get 100 cups, I sell each at 10,000. I'm getting 1 million from just 40,000. That's how valuable coffee is, and that's how we want Ugandans to understand that the value is.
According to the Auditor General's report, by the time the audit was done, only 1 coffee shop out of 5 was operational. Other 2 were not operational, while the 2 were not in existence. But Inspire Africa refutes the findings, saying the report is biased since they were not engaged at the time of the audit.
Auditor General's report was, we think, was biased, and we beg to provide the statistics. We've already worked with the OPM. We've already sent our documents, our statistics, our reports. They are looking at them after that report was tabled in Parliament. And we are hoping that our cry for fairness can be heard.
The company claims they have made a significant contribution in promoting coffee drinking in Uganda, which has seen the number of coffee shops grow from 250 to 1,500 shops since the project was rolled out.
With the intervention of Inspire Africa, and all these projects we implemented, as we speak right now, Uganda has a minimum of 1,500 coffee shops or coffee points where you can grab a cup of coffee. And I can tell you for a fact that Inspire Africa has contributed 40% of that.
Out of the 9.6 billion shillings, 3.831 billion shillings was used to train farmers on the production of coffee, 1.9 billion shillings on establishing coffee shops and attendant infrastructure, 2.65 billion shillings on teaching youths on financial literacy and business management skills, while the project administration cost 1.271 billion shillings. The Public Accounts Committee dispatched a CID police officer to districts of Mbale, Arua, Gulu, Toro and Lira to establish the existence of coffee shops, machines and coffee gardens. Report compiled by Fred Kajuri for the news.